Kodak was the founder of digital camera as well as the film camera. George Eastman was the founder of the Kodak in the year 1888. From 1888 to 1968, they dominated the market. Around 80 years, they dominated the market. 80% was the market share and 80% was the gross margin. The volume was increasing in huge number. The marketing strategy of Kodak was they used to sell three things. First is the camera, the film, and the Kodak paper. They used to sell the camera at low margin and the Kodak film and Kodak paper at the high margin. In fact, Kodak is the company which brought the professional photography to an amateur photography. They introduced various punchlines like you press the button, we'll do the rest, Kodak smile and Kodak moments.
They were following the razor blade technique in which they were selling the razor in low margin and the blade in quite high margin. Means they were selling the camera in quite low margin and the paper and the film in quite high margin. But as said, the only thing that is constant, that is change. Soon after, the blade integrated into the razor and the photographic camera was replaced by the digital camera. The reason behind this was the digital camera was low in cost and the clarity of photo was much more better than them, and literacy amongst the audience or the consumer was increasing. You must be wondering why Kodak does not find the problem or does not do anything. But the Kodak was the first company to innovate the digital camera in 1975. Steve was the engineer of Kodak who designed the first digital camera. It was of 0.1 megapixel. But they were not focusing on the digital camera. This is a great example of missing out opportunity of first advantage. They were not focusing on the digital camera. They were thinking of their photofilmic camera. They were not focusing. They were busy in fighting with Fuji Films. That Fuji Films were selling the film paper in low cost. But they were not focusing on the digital camera. That means they were fighting against the wrong competition. Their competition was digital camera, not Fuji Films. Means that fighting against wrong competition can kill your actual business.
Soon the Kodak realized that they were falling in, there was a decline in sales. So they called their market intelligence team to see into the future. And the marketing team suggested that there will be shift in core technology, in which they told that the digital camera will replace the film cameras. But the Kodak felt that the touch and feel photograph experience can never be replaced by digital cameras. Digital cameras cannot give that emotions which a real photograph has. And also the high margins in the photo film and photo paper were very high. Kodak was declining in the sales, so they called the scientist, who was a very famous scientist at that time, Gunther, and asked the Gunther, what do you look in the future? And the Gunther says that the future is digital. During that time, an article was published in 1984 by Forbes that Kodak world is moving forward and Kodak is falling back. But their reflective listening was so bad that they didn't focus on digital camera and started fighting with Forbes, that the Forbes communist is a man of low intelligence. This reflects that top management lacks in reflective listening about their blind spots.
By that time, many competitors were arriving in the market, Canon, Fujifilm, Sony. This was a big drawback for Kodak, as they were the first to invent the digital, but they were not getting proper advantage of that point. They were not listening to the scientists, media, and their own team. When you are too busy in conveying your own intelligence, this can be a big drawback of yours. They were clinging to the past and were not focusing on their future. The future was digital market. During that time, approximately 10,000 employees lost their job in Kodak. And Kodak tried to bounce back in the market. In 2001, they launched a digital camera in the market, but it does not help in decline in sale. The sales were continuously declining. From 2001 to 2011, 90% of the sale fall down in the market of Kodak. And this was this huge decline, there was a huge decline in profitability, and there was no external funding, no external help provided to Kodak by anyone. And eventually in 2012, Kodak was bankrupted. Conclusion. They missed out opportunity of first mover advantage. They have a huge advantage that they can excel in digital camera, but they continuously fight against the wrong competition, which killed their market. And second, fighting against the wrong competition, which was actually killing their business. Kodak was not focusing on the digital market, and they were focusing on fighting against Fuji films, giving replies to Forbes magazines, etc. They were not focusing on digital market. And last, self-praising syndrome. Their scientists and their team were continuously telling about the problems, that this is the problem, but Kodak themselves was not properly investigating about their blind spot, and they were not focusing on the digital camera. Thank you.
Thank you.